Welcome back to the SST class. Good morning to all. Okay, in our previous class, in our previous video, we have learned about the chapter. In this video, we are going to learn question answers of that chapter. Okay, we have some exercise now. We are going to learn about that. Okay, first, take your course book, SST course book, and there is an exercise, page number 9. Page number 9, exercise. First question, tick the correct option. First one, what does the word geo mean? Do you know what does the word geo mean? There are options, the earth, the world, the land. And the correct option is the world. Second one, this is a model of the earth. The options are a map, a globe, an atlas. And the answer is an atlas. Third one, different symbols and colors are used in a map to show natural features, locations, both of these. The answer is for both of these. Then the Roman letter 2, fill in the blanks. First one, geography explains natural disasters such as floods, dash and volcanoes. Answer is earthquakes. Second one, the globe looks like a miniature version of the dash. Answer is earth. Third one, a dash is a drawing of the earth on a flat surface such as paper. Answer is map. Fourth one, a book having several maps is called a dash. Answer is atlas. Then the Roman letter 3, rearrange the jumbled words. First one, atlas. Second one, globe. Third one, map. Fourth one, miniature. And last, fifth one, spherical. Next, answer the following questions. Answer the following questions. First question, can you mention any three ways geography is useful in everyday life? Answer is, first point, geography helps us to learn about the location of a place. Then the second point, geography helps us to choose the correct route to a destination. Third one, geography gives us information about air, water and land. Then the second question, how are globes useful in learning geography? Answer is, first point, it shows the true shape of the earth. Second point, it helps us to know the location of the continents and oceans on the earth's surface. Then the last point, by spinning a globe, we get an idea how the earth turns on its axis. Next, third question, what is a map? Answer is, a map is a drawing of an earth or a part of it on a flat surface such as paper. Once again, I will read this question, listen it. What is a map? A map is a drawing of the earth or a part of it on a flat surface such as paper. Fourth question, give two reasons why maps are more useful than globes. Answer is, a map gives more information about a place on the earth than a globe. Different colors and symbols are used to show the details. Answer the following is over. Next, in our exercise, there is one more. Do it yourself. Which one shows the true shape of the earth? Globe shows the true shape of the earth. Then the next question. Which one of these is easier to carry around? Map or globe? Yeah, correct. Map is easier to carry around. Then, I have given some extra questions in the notebook. I am going to read that. Listen it carefully. First, choose the correct option. First question, the shape of earth is orange shaped. Second question, globe is the true model of earth. Third question, the blue color on the map shows water bodies. The blue color on the map shows water bodies. Fourth one, geography helps us destination. Fifth one, a map is the dash of the earth, drawing of the earth. Then Roman letter 2, match the following. Globe, answer is model of earth. Map, answer is flat surface. Blue, answer is water bodies. Green, answer is plains. Brown, answer is mountain. Then the third one, fill in the blanks. The mountains, hills, valleys and deserts are called dash landforms. Geography describes the dash and the people living there, landscape. Geography describes the dash and the people living there, landscape. Third one, a map is a drawing of the earth or a part of it on a dash surface such as paper. Flat. Fourth one, a map gives dash information about a place on the earth than a globe. More information about a place on the earth than a globe. Fifth one, a globe is a dash of the earth. A globe is a model of the earth. Then answer the following. First question, what is a continent? A continent is one of the seven mainland areas of the earth. So what is continent? A continent is one of the seven mainland areas of the earth. Second question, what is an ocean? A large body of salt water. What is ocean? A large body of salt water is ocean. Third question, what is globe? Answer is, a globe is a model of the spherical earth which looks like a miniature version of it. A globe is a model of the spherical earth which looks like a miniature version of it. So this much I have written in the notebook. You are also going to write. Now let's learn about the workbook question. Do you all have this workbook? Yes. Take the workbook. Page number 1. First one, fill in the blanks. Geography helps us to choose the correct dash to a destination. Route to a destination. Then, second one, geography helps us to learn about the dash of a place. Location of a place. Third one, both landforms and water bodies are the dash of the earth. Physical features of the earth. Both landforms and water bodies are the dash of the earth. Physical features of the earth. Fourth one, a book that has many maps is called an atlas. A book that has many maps is called an atlas. Fifth one, geography explains the different types of dash, climate and seasons, weather. Geography explains the different types of dash, climate and seasons, weather. Second one, complete the following word associations. Geo means earth. Graphy, the process of writing or describing something. First one, geo means earth. Graphy, the process of writing or describing something. Second one, physical geography, land, water and air. Human geography, people, their language, culture and way of life. Third one, rivers, seas and oceans, water bodies, mountains, valleys and desert is a landform. Then fourth one, monsoon, summer, winter, seasons, earthquakes, volcanoes and floods, that all natural disasters. Fifth one, a map that shows physical features such as mountains, deserts and rivers. Physical map, a map that shows countries, continents and cities, that is political map. Third one, write words that best explain each of the following statement. First one, features of the earth that are not created by humans. What is that? Natural features. Second one, the roads or paths that you use when you go from one place to another place. What is that? Route. An area of land that has a particular look, that is landscape. Fourth one, a model of the spherical earth, that is globe. Fifth one, a drawing of the earth or a part of it on a flat surface, that is map. Next, Roman letter 4. Analyze the following statements for correctness. Correct the wrong statement. They have given the statement. If the statement is wrong, we should correct that. First question, a map gives less information about a place on earth than a globe. Is this a correct one? The correct answer is, a map gives more information about a place on earth than a globe. Second one, on maps and globes, the color green shows water bodies and the color red shows land. And the correct answer is, on maps, the globes, the color blue shows water bodies and the color green shows land. Third question, besides describing the earth, geography teaches us about the sun, the moon, the stars and other planets. Fourth one, a map is a miniature version of the earth. And the correct answer is, a globe is a miniature version of the earth. Fifth one, an atlas has maps that show features of a place such as its climate, rainfall, pattern and crops grown. Answer is, an atlas has maps that show features of a place such as its climate, rainfall, pattern and crops grown. Then Roman letter 5, match the words given below to the pictures. They have given the pictures. We should write the correct word of that picture. First one, the first picture shows volcano. Second picture shows globe. Third picture shows winter. Fourth picture shows map. And the fifth picture shows root. Then Roman letter 6. Answer the following questions in 2 to 3 sentences. First question, what are the advantages of using a globe? First point, it shows the true shape of the earth. By spinning a globe, we get an idea how the earth turns on its axis. Second one, what are the advantages of using a map? Maps gives us the location of a place. Map can be carried around easily. Third question, what is human geography? The branch of geography dealing with how human activity affects or it's influenced by the earth surface is known as human geography. Fourth one, how does geography help in understanding natural disaster? Geography tells us what causes these disasters and how we can prepare and protect ourselves from them. Fifth question, how are air, water and land useful to us? We need air to breathe, we need water to drink, we need land to live. So learn these questions properly, and if any doubt is there, means you see in class dojo and write it in your notebook. Thank you.